The purpose of this video is to introduce you to the lay earth mover slash speed mover. For the purposes of this video, we are actually scraping a layer of clay, which is the remnants of a pile that they had hauled in. They little by little used it up in order to fill holes out in the lot, and there's still a thin 2 to 4 inch layer out there on top of the dirt. And we chose to use this rather than actually using it in a feedlot, because working with this clay layer is actually harder than working with a manure layer. And we wanted to be able to show you how easily it will peel up a clay layer, and therefore it will do the same thing in a feedlot while it's peeling up the manure layer. They work kind of like a razor, where they just shave the dirt off. And if you want to shave off just an inch or so, you can do it. If you want to shave off 2 to 4 inches, you can do that too. As the bucket gets full, you'll see in different portions of the video that it will actually build up some of the dirt in between the tongue in front of the crossbar. And even though the unit will only carry around 2 yards of dirt, if you're using it in this position, you can actually drag anywhere from 4 to 6 yards of dirt, just kind of depending on how full that area between the tongue is. I have seen some cases where, and if the soil conditions are right, you can actually fill it up as high as what that scarifer bar is, all the way up to the jack, and it'll actually be building up around the jack area too. Later on in the video, we do show a short clip using a 3-point version where it is just showing the 3-point loading. It does not show the 3-point unloading like we're doing here. I did not feel any purpose of that because they virtually unload the same way. We did shoot some video using the scarifers down where they were tearing the dirt up as it was loading, but it didn't come out very good because the sun reflected off the back window of the tractor and you really couldn't see very well. But we really couldn't see any difference between how it loaded. It really loaded just as good with the scarifers up as it did with the scarifers down. So that really doesn't make any difference. Unit, where we're doing it here, we're using it with about a 200 horsepower tractor, which is really about all you ever want to put in front of one. Definitely not over 250 horsepower in front of any of the units. You don't need it, because as you're moving the dirt, once the bucket gets full, then all you're really dragging is the dirt that is in front of the bucket. And with the bucket carrying 2 to 2.5, 3 yards, and all the dirt in front of it is all you're actually dragging. So it doesn't take any horsepower to carry the dirt. So the dirt you're dragging in front is all you're really needing the horsepower for. And the same thing goes with 3-point bar, although you can't build up a lot of dirt in front of the blade on the 3-point bar, because then the tires will start dragging it out. You have to close the bucket and lift it up and carry it using the 3-point bar. And as you can see, it has no problems dragging the soil or peeling it up. In the 3-point version, we're digging a little bit deeper. We're trying to go all the way down to the black layer at one time. As you can see here in the next portion, it has no problem doing that. It gets down in there, gets down to the black layer right away in most situations. Not all the time did we get down there, but in most of the cases we did. And as you can see here in this portion, it leaves it pretty smooth when